Hey there, Minecrafters. It's Minecraft Grand, the geeky Minecrafter, bringing you a new video. Today, it might be a little bit of a long video. We've got a few things to cover. Basically, I'm going to be building a mob farm, and rather than just jump in at the end or in the middle, I'm actually going to start you at the beginning. Resource gathering, planning, laying it out, putting it together. We're going to do the whole thing. Now, this might wind up being a multi-video series. I hope you'll excuse that. I've had a lot of requests to do it start to finish, you know, show all the steps in between. So that's what I'm going to do. Now, there may be videos in between these because, you know, it's an ongoing process. And I am playing on multiple servers. So I think what we'll do is we'll get started. I am planning to build this particular mob farm on Cherry Vanilla. So if you're ready, come on, let's get started. Looks like I've made a few sales. Let's see what... Oh, nice. Look at this. Okay, somebody asked me to get on Grand. So let's just tell them another time. Because, you know, they want to chat, and I love chatting with them. I get on TeamSpeak all the time. But, you know, I don't necessarily want to... Don't want to necessarily talk on that. So sorry, Yeti. Maybe another time. Okay. So I am in Cherry Vanilla. This is my base. It's my hobbit hole, if you will. Now my hobbit hole has grown, and as you can see, I've got a nether portal and an enchant room. And I know I've shown you all this, so I'm not gonna do the whole tour. There's one of my exits. Now this is the area. See, I've been growing a bunch of trees out there. Whew, excuse the technical difficulties there. I am having some driver issues still. So, like I'm saying, I've been planting some trees out there, been growing some wood. A couple of players have helped me out. They've been contributing some wood. Now, I did add to the... Let me just explain something to you here. I added down here to the sort room. And before you get mad at me, I thought I recorded it, okay? I came in, did a full video, showed all of this going in, setting the filters, adding all of this stuff in here, only to discover when I was ready to stop the video that, guess what? That's right, it was on pause. I need to put a big old sticky note right in the center of the screen when I start recording because sometimes I forget. Come on, I'm a grandmother, you know, memory is one of the first things to go, so sorry about that, you missed that video. But I do have some dark oak here, and some birch going in down here, and I do believe, just like the other mob farm that I created here on Cherry Vanilla, that I think I want dark oak and birch. Now, as you can see, it's going right up there. As a part of getting ready for this, I've done a few little calculations. I know that I'm going to need quite a bit of material. Having built this now a couple of times, I know I'm going to need pretty much a double stack, a double chest worth of wood. About half dark oak and about half birch. As you can see, I've been replanting out here. So I just come out and knock them down and replant them and then go inside and mine for a little bit. I am going to need scaffolding, I need iron for the tools and the hoppers and all like that. So a part of building the mob farm is getting ready for it, and that means spending some time down in the mine. So, let's see, I've got three new trees. I'll plant one there, and one over here, and one right here. And then I've been planting the oak, not because I plan to build with it, but because sticks and planks and chests can all be an oak. All the stuff that you know, that isn't really going to be seen by everybody, I do out of oak. It's because it grows fast. You can grow them right together. See how I did a line here? I just create a fence wall, and they'll all grow right together. I love that. None of the other trees do that. Hey, Minecraft. Hey, Mahjong. You know, it'd be great if all the trees did that, don't you think? You know, as long as we're talking to Mahjong, hey. We've got some really cool new blocks like andesite and diorite and granite. It would be awesome if we could make half slabs and stairs out of those. So pretty much anything, you know, like stone or brick or cobble that you can build out of like that, we'd like to be able to make half slabs out of those too. Okay, maybe I'm speaking for everybody, and maybe I really should be saying, this is Minecraft Gran, and I really, really want this. And, you know, could you pay attention? Because I think it would be awesome. Okay, that's enough of that. Mahjong, if you're hearing me, though, you know, it would be great. So I went ahead and knocked these down real fast. I'll grab the saplings and replant them before we go inside, do a little bit of planning, and talk about, you know, what I'm going to need. So we've already said I'm going to need, a double chest full of, actually it's probably going to wind up being closer to two double chests, frankly. I guess it depends on the number of levels. So the platform is, well, we'll just use round numbers. We'll call it 40 by 30. And that's for each level. Each level has a floor and a ceiling, and although we pull some of the floor out because, you know, we have the place where they can be washed away, right? It's still, you know, you have to kind of plan on that. So let's see, where is this? There it is. Oh, I love me some instant decay. So check this out. I still have. Oh, I only see one. Maybe one of them finally went away. So, a horse over here in my area got struck by lightning. Of course, the game now spawns in the four horsemen of the apocalypse. So they're out here, they're fighting me, they're killing me. I ran in the house, I clicked the lock. Unfortunately, the lock locked it while the door was open. So they're still shooting me. Oh, it was horrific. I still have five left, so we'll just do them over here. Again, this is my, what I call my material, you know, for all that other stuff. So let's do this, and let's put up some of what we have. So that's not bad. That's a stack and a half of oak, and that'll make quite a few chests. You need chests for hoppers, you need chests for storage. You need oak for sticks, so pretty much going to be using a lot of that. Now, as you can see, my levels are up to 34. Yay, they opened up the Enderman farm down at the end and was able to run in there and grab some levels. I have been doing some enchanting, and I do have a couple of really cool tools now that I can use as a part of the mining effort. And again, gotta mine because you need the material. I'm thinking I'll make the sides in the wood and the floor in cobblestone. Cobblestone I have a truckload of, and it's, you know, it's plentiful, it's cheap, it's a byproduct of everything I'm doing. Let's see, I've managed to get efficiency 4, unbreaking 3, fortune 3, so I use my silk touch to pick up a diamond ore. Then I come up here and I break it with the Fortune 3. I do have another Efficiency 4, Unbreaking 3. I have two more. Those are my backups. Now, I'm using this one up because, you know, you have to. Been spending that down in the mine. And I've got, I've got some good tools. I've got a pretty good, I've got a pretty good wood axe there. I've got a pretty good wood axe there. Because I'm on my third or fourth one already. I have been mining a lot of trees, so let's do this. I've got a little food. Oh, I forgot to put these up. So let's go down and let me show you. You know what? I think I'll take you on a quick tour of the end. Show you what he's created out there. I'm really impressed with it. It's a fast XP, and as you can see, I have 34 levels. And I just did a bunch of enchanting. So I love Cherry Vanilla because they have home points. I have up to 6. I have one that I have placed down at the end so I can just jump down there and grab some XP and then run and go do some more. So I'll run back the long way down the long hall there and show you how to get to it. So I just run back and forth here and wail on these guys. And as you can see, it jumps your XP up quite a bit. Uh-oh. Down below here, this is where the Ender Pearls are. It looks like somebody's got... I Light on is waste off. So somebody, it looks like somebody left it running, so it's dumped all the ender pearls out into lava. So just FYI, you know, if you come down here and they're full, feel free to turn it on. Leave it on while you're playing up here, and then turn it back off when you leave so that there are ender pearls for other people. So we'll just wail on them a little bit, show you that, you know, they'll collect. Just a little here. And again, you gotta love TMH. He does provide for player needs. There is an enchant table here. There are a couple of Mushu cows. And there are, oh, it looks like people are dumping extra stuff. But normally there's, you know, bowls, and you can go get you some mushroom soup if you need to eat. Because whaling on these guys does take some energy, right, guys? Now, I'm a grandmother. I love me some pumpkin pie. And that's one of the things I'm getting ready for. Let's see. Come on. Really? Where are they? Oh, there we go. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and grab a, you know, another stack of these, because you can always always use some ender pearls. Now, they do provide lockers right down here. And for those of you just joining the server, let me explain how this works in case someone hasn't explained it to you. You find a chest that doesn't have a sign. You open it. You grab the sign. You place the sign on the chest. And then you type lock. Press enter. And then tap the chest that you've just put the sign on. And that'll lock it for you. Nobody else will be able to open it. So these are your player lockers. If you have stuff, you know, like you're enchanting or you want to take some pearls home, you need to leave some stuff here until you come back. That's a good way to do that. Of course, there are ender chests down here. So you have access to that as well. So let's do a quick run back. I have XP and... You know, if you bring a minecart, you can minecart down here really fast. It's, what, a couple hundred blocks. So it's a little bit of a run. Let me eat something. Running, running, running. And we're walking, and we're running. Let me speed this up. And... careful, there's nothing on the other side of that. I was giving somebody a tour down here the other day, and he looked over the edge to see what it was, and he fell off. Now, fortunately, he was able to swim up the water and get back up here, but yes, it's quite a long fall. I think it's a fall all the way to the void, so you want to avoid that. Okay, we're running, we're running. Okay, now I hate running out here. I hate doing this because, you know, I do have to I do have to run through where the Endermen are. Let's eat something up here. Okay, and I think I don't think they're spare in here. Let's see, let me grab this. I don't know. Now, I think that's just to launch you. So if you come down here with a minecart, you know, you can make that trip a little bit faster. I like the endpoints. Now, when you're coming here, you jump, and the water stops you, the break. But if you're, you know, if you want to come out this way, you have to come up the ladder, which is one of the reasons I say make an endpoint. The end winds up being something I use quite frequently because it's such a great way to get XP. And if you want to keep good tools, oh, went the wrong way. Oh, come on. Okay, so when you jump through the end portal, you'll land right here. So there's the end farm, and then there's the end island. Let's see. Oh, goodness. You know, I don't think I've ever gone back from here. Ooh, this could be scary. This will be an adventure. Please, Lord, let me get this right. Oh, it looks like it's over there. Okay. What do we have here? Oh, hello. Okay, so follow the street signs, it looks like. Alright. Yeah, really. you know, give me a pumpkin head for over here. I don't like wandering around where the Endermen are, because, you know, part of me, I feel guilty because I've been wailing on them over at the end farm, right? And the other part of me is like, you know, come on. You deserve it. You hit so hard. Okay, I think. Why, yes, it is. Now, this will jump us right back to spawn. How did they do that? This is my bedroom. I'm going to have to ask somebody about that. Okay, well, that was the tour. Now, let me show you what we have planned out here. So, we were just popped into my bedroom. Not sure how that happened, but we did. I have a mountaintop right up here. It gets a little scary over here because, you know, there's not much to hang on to. Oh, did you see that? I almost fell right there. I don't have steps yet, so I'm going to do the sneak hop. It's like a little bunny hop, you know. Put your left foot in. No, that's something else. Okay, I'm going to use this for staging. I'm going to come out to here. I'm going to build up from here. Now, I can build up, say, another 80 blocks. So that I'm not being impacted by the caverns that are around here, all the mobs being able to spawn underground. So that's one of the reasons I build it so high. So I'll go 40 up to the platform, and then 40 beyond that to the bottom layer of the mob farm, so that they have a 40-block fall that will make them pancakes. Except, you know, witches sometimes survive a 40-block fall, and occasionally zombies with armor survive. I don't know how, but they do occasionally. So 40 plus 40, that's 80 total, and then it'll go up, I don't know, 2, 3, 4 levels, something like that. I don't want to put too big a drain on the server. Now that I'm doing, you know, my own server maintenance, I understand the value of keeping, you know, things down on a per-player basis, because, you know, you're handling, the server's got a lot to handle. So, I'm going to try and be respectful. Let's see, where'd it go? Is it right here? Yes. I hate this part. I always almost fall. Let's see, right here. Okay, so let's see. We've talked about the wood. We've talked about the cobblestone, the building material. I do need, I need some more dark oak. Last time I was out here, I wound up harvesting it right into the night. And I did not have time to replant these, because, you know, you kind of have to be careful with these. You want to make sure they're in an area where they'll grow. They can be four. You know, you have to put them down in groups of four, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I ran out of time. Now, I do have an area not far from me that I have been harvesting in. And let me just go ahead and run over there and show you where that is. Plant a couple. Oh, I thought I saw a creeper. You know, those creepers have me about ready to jump out of my skin. Every time I turn around, somebody is blowing me up. Let's see, I think it's right through here. Yep, I got my little torch trail out here. So, cool, isn't this cool? This is dark oak right here. Oh, looks like that's where my skelly horses ran to. They're over here in the dark oak forest. Now, I have to be careful over here. This one I don't mine in at night because it's pretty dark, even though I've lit it up. There are a lot of skeletons and zombies that come in here. So, let's just mine a little bit of, or mine, farm, whatever. Let's cut a little bit of wood. This is a let's play. Like to do the look around. Call me scary, call me skittish, but I'm telling you, I will be working away. And creepers are silent. Maybe that's why they got the name creepers. They're silent. So you'd be working along, not paying attention. You're listening for zombies. You're listening for skeletons. Heck, you're even listening for cows and sheep, and you hear them coming. And the next thing you know, you're just blowing up. Well, I have room to replant that, don't I? 2, 3, 4. Yeah, try to not harvest it and leave it where it's, you know, because I'm not the only one in this area. In fact, I have a couple of neighbors. So, neighbors, if you're watching this, howdy. Welcome to the neighborhood. Been here mining for a little while, so word of warning. I went down to bedrock and started mining, and I've encountered a couple of mines. You know, my strips are about 500 wide. So, if you're finding my mines, my slits, I apologize. That's what's going on, though. Oops. Not trying to be unneighborly. As a matter of fact, if it winds up being a problem, I may wind up having to move my operation. I'll just put a nether portal in, well, portal back, and use the mob farm. And okay, any of you cherry vanilla players out there, listen up. You want to help with this, either by contributing time, effort, or materials, I will be happy to cut you in on the drops. Now, I do plan to sell a lot of the drops in my shop. I do have a shop now in town. So if you have, you know, if you want to participate, really, I only got two out of that. Huh. Oh, no. Here we go. Five. That, I thought so. There's a couple more. All right. I was getting worried there for a second. So we'll put that one back. And we'll take one more down, and then we'll go back to the house. See, this is why I have to do all these enchanting. Like I said, this is my fourth or fifth axe. Even though they've got efficiency on them, I've got like an unbreaking 2, I think. I'm still working trying to get that unbreaking 3, because, boy, that makes a difference in your tools, doesn't it? I've always been a big believer in the right tool for the job and taking care of your tools. I mean, in real life, you know, you oil them, you take care of them, you're careful with them, they'll last you a long time. I've got tools I've had, you know, that I've owned for 30 years that are just as good today as they were the day I bought them. But Minecraft, you know, doesn't account for, am I taking care of my tools? Am I, you know, am I cleaning and polishing? Am I oiling it? Am I sharpening it? Oh, new neighbor. New build over here. What is going on here? A skyway? Huh. Okay, cool build. Now, I knew about this guy over here. He's got a bunch of farming going on over there. As a matter of fact, from the sky, from the Dyne map, you know, he has just got a really huge farm. I may show that to you in just a sec. Let's see, how can I get... I think my house is over here. Yeah, here we go. See how close? Now, to be fair, I was here first. You may not have known I was here because I wasn't building outside. I did all my initial building inside. So, you know, I forgive you. I'm sorry. But sorry that my mind might be interfering. So let's put this extra stuff up. Let's go throw the wood in the chest. And let's decide, what do we need to do next? Sorry for the whistles. Still getting used to my dentures. Let's see, we've got plenty of food. I've got a little bit of wood. I mean, I've got enough wood to get started. Maybe laying it out. And I definitely have enough cobblestone to get started. Let's see. What do we have down here in the way of dark? You know, I know I'm going to need probably at least one double, maybe two double chests of wood. Now, you know, half of one, half of the other. I don't know why I did this as planks. That's just not the most efficient way to store that, is it? I may go fix that. So do I have enough to get started? Maybe lay out the boundaries? Build my initial platform? Let me think. Boy, decisions. Let's do this. Let me show you this guy. My neighbor, the one I just was telling you, has a really big farm. So this is him. This is his farmed area right here. This is that little guy with the sky bridge we just walked past. And then, of course, down here is the valley that I ran through. And as you can see, let's see, there's the little bridge over to that little sky island. So for my whole area, this map doesn't show any part of what I have or am building. My cows are over here. You can see some of the trees, but that's it. So ultimately, I'm hoping I get neighbors in here in the mountains. We can share resources or, build stuff together. But I don't even know who these people are over here, these guys. They're off doing their thing, and that's cool. Don't get me wrong. That's cool. But I don't know who they are. I do know that they've already raided the village. There's not really anything left over there to be concerned with. I mean, I was hoping to, grab a couple of villagers, get started breeding them, maybe build an iron farm, but that's not to be. Okay, so I showed you the map. You know what? It's time to go mining. So I'm going to head down here. I know you don't really want to watch mining. Just going to show you a couple of improvements that I've made, and then I'll end the video here and let you go. You stay tuned for the next one. In the next one, I'm going to definitely get started laying it out. We'll build the initial platforms, but I need probably at least one row in a double chest worth of logs, and maybe two rows of cobblestone to get started with. As you can see, I've been busy, been down here mining. Each one of these are, 250 blocks long, and there are, I think at last count, 14 of them. So I'm definitely, pulling some stuff out of there. I'm spending it almost as fast as I get it, making the tools to keep going. Let's see, where do I have? Yeah, see, and I built a bunch of hoppers, so I'm down to, I've used up almost all of it. I do have the diamond ore that I was setting aside. I do now have a fortune pick. Yay! So, the next time I'm down here, or the next time I head up from mining, I'll go use that. So, let's see. Let's set up. Excuse me. I know I said before that I didn't like the combat update because, this offhand is a little bit crazy. So I have discovered, 1, 2, 3, 4, I have discovered why to love it. Let me show you that. Oh, let me go grab a gate. Just in case, don't want anybody getting in my mind. So one for the front, one for the back. We'll start with two. So I've discovered why to love it. To me, it was a little confusing when you're whaling along, and if you wanted to lay down a torch, you would right-click, right? Or correct. You would right... Let me try that again. You would right-click, correct, just pow, right-click. Well, that only works if the item you have in your good hand, your main hand, does not have a left-click option or a right-click option, like setting a stone. Okay, setting a stone is right-click. So if I was anticipating putting a torch up now and I right-clicked, boom, I didn't get a torch, I got a stone. So if what you're holding, it doesn't have a right-click item or option, then it will stone-click, okay? So I do put my torches in my left hand, my offhand, and I do place the torches with this. Let me do one more here. So I have found that it's a little easier to mine. I'm not having to switch hands so often. And I do like that. Now, maybe if I was carrying a sword and a shield, for combat, I could see, left click being whale on somebody and right click being throw the sword or the shield up. I could see that. But it's what you're used to, right? That's what I think. Okay, so let's see. I think we've covered it all. Oh, isn't that an interesting glitch? Ooh, hello, hello. I'm out here in the middle of nowhere. Can you see me? Can you see me? Nope. Okay. Let's try backing up. There we go. Get out of the glitch. So this is Minecraft Grand, the geeky Minecrafter, signing out. Hope you enjoyed this intro video. Let me go get some materials. If you're planning to build your own mob farm, we're going to need... let me grab my list here and I'll run it by you. You're going to need at least 350 hoppers. You're going to need at least 40 chests. You're going to need probably a double run of redstone. at least a double chest worth of wood and a double chest worth of cobblestone. Now, all the detail work, you know, if you want to make it pretty, plan on adding that, glass, stuff like that. You're definitely going to need a lot of torches to make sure that where you're working, they can't spawn in. And then once the once it starts running, of course, you know, the inside of this box is going to be completely dark. Did I mention dispensers? You're going to need, I think it's 14 per level, 4 levels, you know, so 10, 20, 30, 4, 38, 40, you know, 45-ish will work. You're also going to need that many buckets of water. So, you know, start gathering your resources. Get your bows, get your dispensers, get your materials, and check back in with me for the next video. So, till next time, happy mining. This is the Geeky Minecrafter, Minecraft Grand, checking out.